We can finally return to the question that kind of motivated us all with Aaron Brockovich, which is, let's say we have some contamination in the groundwater. We want to sue somebody. There are two things that we need to prove. We need to prove first that the water is actually contaminated, and second, that you know that the source of that contamination is who you're actually suing, that those people are actually responsible. And so let's take a look at what we've learned about groundwater flow and try and put all that together. So let's say that you live here at C, point C, and your groundwater is contaminated. You figure that out by taking a groundwater sample out of your groundwater monitoring well, just sort of sucking out some of the water there and sending it off to a lab to be analyzed. So the question is, could that water have come from the factory at point A? Well, what you do is you backtrack, basically. We had talked about how at point A, the groundwater flows this way. Well, you learned just a few moments ago that at point C, the water traces back over here, not so close to point B, somewhere in between, maybe. And so you're able to figure out where did this contamination come from and blame them and hopefully sue them. So we're going to practice that in Matador City. We're going to be working on two different versions of the simulation here to try and figure out who has contaminated the bay in Matador City. And we're going to start off with one practice round, which looks with a little bit of the city that looks like this here. So what you'll do is go back to Moodle, find that groundwater challenge, and you'll see a screen that kind of looks like this. It's going to have a map with a bunch of grid cells, and the grid cells are just there, the letters and numbers, to help you sort of see that, okay, this one's cell D5, and it's going to help us talk about a particular location where you can put a well. And you can put a well at any one of these little crossing points here. If you want to make a well, you can select a drilling a well tool, and it's going to cost you $1,000. You can see your balance is right there. And then after you've drilled a well, should you choose to, you may collect a water sample. It'll only cost you $100. The screen also will show you a little status box. It will give you some feedback and some instructions here. And at the end of the round, we'll have you submit your answers using the submit button down there. So this is what our practice city looks like. So let's take a look. So you get oriented. See if you can try and get the drill tool activated and click on cell B6. And we want to figure out which way does groundwater flow from B6. Well, we don't have any contour map in this particular picture, so what we'll have to do is, when we click on cell B6, we see that the height of the groundwater table is 20 meters above sea level. Well, that only helps us a little bit because we want to know what the elevation of the groundwater table is in the areas around us. And so what we'll do is we'll have to drill, in this particular case to get ourselves started, wells at all these other spots and look and see. And we said that water will flow downslope. Well, let's see. Okay, groundwater could flow downslope from 20 to 14. That sounds downslope. Or you could look for where the water is going to go the steepest downslope, for the biggest change in elevation, and that's going to be in this direction from 20 to 10, which is the direction that the water will actually flow in this case. Now, maybe if you're pretty sure that you know that the water is going to be flowing down towards the ocean, you may not have to drill all of these wells to figure out which way the water is flowing. But that's a strategy that you'll have to figure out as you go through the practice round here. What's going to happen next is you're going to see a variety of other questions like this for the practice round that you're going to work out and answer in some questions with comments here as you get used to how this works, how to trace the flow of groundwater and contamination through this sample city. So let's go to it.